Hello, dear students, welcome to the video lecture series. In this lecture, we will be discussing the concept of feedback in amplifiers. This presentation is created and narrated by Hemant Satpute, teacher, Department of Electronic Science, Fergusson College, Junior Wing, Pune. Well, in this first lecture, we will be discussing the general concept of feedback, concept of feedback in amplifiers, definition of feedback, and two major types of feedback. Well, let me begin the general concept of feedback. Dear students, have you given a thought that while studying a particular subject or a particular curriculum during our college life, why one has to go or one has to face different examinations like unit test exam, term end exam, then once again another unit test, another term end exam, theory exam, practical exam, and then final board exam? Have you even ever thought? Why not it happened that you go on studying in 2 years the subject as per your own time, as per your own space, and just give one single exam, final board exam, at the end? Why not this happens? It doesn't happen because of the concept of feedback. Because if you make a mistake in the final exam, then it might happen that you may lose your marks or your score might be very, very low, or because of this low score you might lose the rank. This should not happen. That's why at suitable stages, in suitable time difference span, number of tests have been taken and you have been judged whether you have understood the topics which you have taught to you, whether you are able to grasp the subject contents, whether you are able to reproduce those subject contents. If there are any mistakes, if you are falling weak in a particular subject, then you should have a proper time, you should have sufficient amount of time to repair those concepts, to restudy those concepts, and again give the second exam, so that at the time of final exam you will be fully prepared for the final exam and you will be scoring a good percentage of marks to achieve your goals. Here, the exams which we are considering, these exams are a part of a feedback of your progress to your school, to the colleges, to your teachers, to your parents, as well as to you also. So this is the general concept of feedback. In everyday life, we always take a feedback. Concept of feedback in amplifiers. Amplifiers are not the only things where the feedback is used. We use idea of feedback in our daily life too. You may not have realized it, but even we use feedback in the progress of learning. One example I had already given you. This is the second example. When a child is asked to write a letter A, he will probably write it as shown in the following figure A. When he finds that the stroke is not going in the correct direction, then the information goes to his brain through the eyes. The brain immediately orders the hand to correct the directions of the stroke. With much effort and with constant feedback, the child writes the letter A as shown in this figure. So initially, when you start writing, you will get these kinds of strokes. But when your brain receives feedback about it, then it is corrected, and upon getting a proper feedback, you will be writing the proper letter A in its proper format. So this is the use of feedback in our daily life. The important characteristics of an amplifier are its voltage gain, input impedance, output impedance, and bandwidth. So these parameters are more or less constant for a given amplifier. Thus, the designer does not have any control over them. Quite often, the values of these parameters are required to be changed. This could be done in various ways. For example, voltage gain can be reduced by using resistive network, either in the input or in the output. Also, the input impedance of an amplifier can be increased by connecting a series resistance. But these methods results in a wastage of useful signal. So, there is another powerful method to do this, and which is known as feedback in the amplifier circuit. Now, this is the definition of feedback. So, feedback is the process of taking part of the output signal and feeding it back to the input circuit. I'll repeat, feedback is the process of taking part of output signal and feeding it back to the input circuit. Depending upon whether the feedback energy increases or decreases the input signal, there are two basic types of feedbacks in amplifiers, that is positive feedback and negative feedback. Let's discuss positive feedback. When feedback energy, that is either voltage or current, is in phase with the input signal and thus aids it, it is called positive feedback. Positive feedback increases the gain of the amplifier. However, it has the disadvantage of increased distortion and instability. Therefore, positive feedback is rarely used in amplifier circuit. But the use of this feedback is more prominent or more frequent in oscillators, which leads to oscillations. Second type of feedback is negative feedback. So, when the feedback energy, either voltage or current, is out of phase with the input signal and thus opposes it, it is called as a negative feedback. So, negative feedback reduces the gain of the amplifier. The advantage of negative feedback are reduction in distortion, stability in gain, increase in bandwidth, and improved input and output impedances. Due to these advantages, the negative feedback is frequently used in amplifiers. Well, dear students, that's all for today's lecture. Stay tuned for the next lecture in this series.